We want to solve the system of equations using the substitution method, which is an algebraic method for solving a system of equations. To solve a system of equations, we want to find an ordered pair or an x and y value that would satisfy both of the equations. But we do have to keep in mind that it is possible that there may be no solution or even an infinite number of solutions to a system of equations. To keep things organized, let's call this equation 1 and we'll call this equation 2. The first step in the substitution method is to solve one of the equations for one of the variables. Luckily, if we take a look at equation 2, it's already solved for y. We have y equals 5/2 x minus 5. The next step in the substitution method is to use this equation here that solved for y and perform substitution into equation 1. Meaning if we know that y is equal to 5/2 x minus 5, we can replace y in the first equation with 5/2 x minus 5. Doing this will give us an equation with one variable. So by performing this substitution, equation 1 would be 5x minus 2 times, instead of y, we'll have 2 times 5/2 x minus 5 equals 10. Again, notice how we have an equation with one variable, in this case x. So now we'll solve this equation for x and then perform back substitution to determine the value of y. So the first step here is going to be to clear the parentheses. So we'll distribute. So we'll have 5x. For this first product, we can think of this as negative 2 over 1. Notice how the 2's would simplify out. So we'd have minus 5x. And then for the second product, we can think of this as negative 2 times negative 5, which is positive 10. So we'd have plus 10 equals 10. Notice how we do have like terms here. And 5x minus 5x is actually 0. So we're left with 10 equals 10. And notice how there's no longer any variable terms. We're left with 10 equals 10. When the variables simplify out and we're left with a true statement or true equation, 10 is always equal to 10. This tells us we have an infinite number of solutions. If the variables simplify out and we're left with a false statement or false equation, we would have no solutions. If you remember when we were solving equations graphically, if a system had an infinite number of solutions, the two equations produced the same line. So let's go ahead and take a moment and look at the graph of these two equations. Well, equation 1 and equation 2 do produce the same line, and therefore they have an infinite number of points in common, which does verify that we have an infinite number of solutions.